Hello beautiful people, it's Burola Olaleko here and you're welcome to my YouTube channel. You want to be a leader and you don't like reading, or you've tried this reading thing and you just can't get yourself to develop this reading habit. It's like it's just not your thing. Or you actually want to read, you started and it has been unproductive or unsuccessful. You find out you are stuck in one book for months. In this video, I'll be sharing some tips and how some things I've applied basically on how to develop a reading habit. Just how to read better, read faster, understand what you are reading, and not just read for reading's sake or just to count the amount of books on your shelf. Number one, don't buy books you don't need. Don't buy books because you see them on the shelf and they look good, or the title is attractive, or just buy books. Because then when you have so many books to read, you become overwhelmed. I'm like, where do I even start? Like, there are so many books to read, I don't know where to start, and everything is just, and you end up not reading any. So don't buy books you don't need. Instead, create a list of books you need. So what I do is, at the end of each month, or towards a new month, towards a new year, I write down a list of books I want to read for that month, and I break it down. When do I want to read this book? I want to read this book this week. So when I see another book that I want to read, I won't buy it until I'm done with this one I've written for this month. So if I'm not done with the one I'm supposed to read for this month, till next month, until I finish that list of books I have before going into another one. Another thing people do most times is you want to finish a book, you just want to read a book, or you just want to finish a book, and you forget or you don't learn anything from that book. I've read several books and I'm like, okay, I finished this book. What did I gain from this book? At the moment or at the point you were reading it, you were like, I like this. This really, you circled or highlighted some things that really stand out or speak into your life. And at the end of the book, you just don't know what you've gotten from the book. Like, what point or what thing have I gotten from this book that I want to apply into my life? If you want what you've read to work in your life, you need to deliberately apply the things you've learned. So it's not always about finishing a book. What I like to do is, when I get a book, I go to the table of contents and see the chapters. Okay, this book, what do I want to learn from this book? Then you go to the content. What part of, or what chapter speaks to my life? For me, it's not compulsory you finish a book. The main thing is learning, getting point from the book. It's your book. You can keep it in your library, on your shelf. When you need it again, you go back and read. The most important thing for me is learning something from the book and applying it to my life, because that is when you see results to be a leader. There are so many people who read, but there's no results. So if you want to see results in your life, if you want to lead, then you need to be able to apply what you've learned from that book. So it's not compulsory you finish your book, just highlight things you want to learn at that time. Chapter one is important for me because then I feel the author or the writer pours their heart out into the first chapter. So I read the first chapter, or you can read like each chapter, read the beginning, read the end, and see if you are interested in reading the whole chapter. Another thing is to always take a book along with you. Yeah, people who use PDF or soft or hard copy, no matter what, always take a book along. There are times we go out or we go to the bank, we don't know how long we are going to spend there. You can always take out a book while waiting, while sitting in the waiting room. Just take out a book and read. Find a quiet place or an atmosphere that suits you. There are people who can read amidst the chaos. They can read in any place, no matter how noisy the place is. They can read. But there are some of us who, if we hear a pin drop, we are distracted. The place has to be quiet, like quiet. And there are some people who can read with music or lo-fi, just something to keep. So find that atmosphere that suits you and create that atmosphere for yourself when you want to read. Get a reading partner. I feel reading is fun when you have someone to discuss what you've learned with and you get to assimilate better, or you have a partner you can share ideas of things you've learned with and you can help each other apply those things. Set daily targets, realistic targets. When I pick up a book, how many pages is this book? How many chapters are there in this book? What do I want to learn from this book? After highlighting the things you want to learn from this book, okay, how many pages can I read a day? How fast do I read? Just set a time to read daily. Okay, I want to read 1 hour daily and stick to that time. Or I want to complete, set target for yourself and make sure you meet that target. It's an habit, and at a point it might be difficult, but something you need to consistently do so it can become an habit. Make yourself read and stay there. Make sure you meet your daily target. Another thing is to stop or reduce one habit that is taking most of your time. Yes, we have just 24 hours in a day, then you have school, you have work, you have this, you have that. There are so many things to do, and you just really can't find that time in your 24 hours to read. Check your day. There is something you are doing that is taking much of your time. If it's TV, if it's social media, try to cut it off and to deliberately develop this reading habit. Try to either minimize the time you use watching TV or social media to read. Okay? Visit the library or have a library day. You cannot. Who goes to the library without reading? So just have a day you can walk into the library and read. You know how long you want to spend in the library. I know when you are there, the library is quiet. You have to read. So once you put it in your schedule, once a week or anytime that suits you, to visit the library, you are more cautious of your reading habits. Make reading enjoyable. Have coloring pens or things you can highlight. It's your book. Have fun with it. Pencils, papers, just write, take notes, and just make it enjoyable. Because there are times you are just staring at this page with words and it can be boring at times. So color them. Do anything fun. Be artistic. Play around with it and make sure you enjoy reading. Do what would make you enjoy reading. Another thing you can do if just sitting down and taking book is not your thing is to try audiobooks. So yes, audiobooks is everywhere. So you can try a few audiobooks and just listen to the books on the go and see which one works for you. You can also try which works for you. Do you prefer reading PDF on your phone or on your laptop, or do you prefer reading the hardcover, just getting the book in your hands and reading? Find out which style works for you and stick to that style. Play around reading. Reading is fun, reading is informative. If you want me to do a book review, let me know in the comment section. I'll be so excited to do that. And if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to give us a like, share with everyone you know, and subscribe to this channel if you are not yet subscribed. Bye guys, and I'll see you in my next video.